Prime Minister Julia Gillard has met with Ford workers in Victoria for the first time since the company announced it would stop manufacturing vehicles in Australia. Rory McLaren joins us now from Geelong, where the meeting took place this afternoon. Rory, exactly what did the Prime Minister have to offer affected Ford employees?
Yeah, good evening, Tash. Well, the Prime Minister has put forward an extra $15 million worth of funding to help Ford employees find new work. Now, of that $15 million, $5 million will come on stream immediately to help with adjustment activities. Now, the Prime Minister received a very warm welcome here at the Geelong Trades Hall. Geelong, of course, is where Ford's engine plant is based and where 510 jobs are set to be lost in 2016. Now, about 80 people met with the Prime Minister, including workers, their families and union reps, and to also hear the announcement and hear and enjoy a question and answer session with her afterwards. Now, the Prime Minister said she wanted to make the trip personally to show the government was standing by the employees in this particularly difficult time. Let's have a little bit of a listen of what she had to say, and we'll also hear for some Ford employees.
I know that there's a lot of pressure on people's shoulders, but there are some things we can do, and what we can do, we will do.
The more we can get, the better, and hopefully we can all get more, get back into the workforce straight away.
We will accept the support that any government wants to give, whether it's state or federal government. We need to keep Geelong strong.
Now, the media were locked out of the question and answer session, but I spoke to some people when it did break up a short time ago. They said that the Prime Minister used some very plain language with them, but they also felt like they got something out of her presence and the meeting. So, Tash, there is still a lot of work to do right across Victoria for workers who have been affected by Ford's decision to cease manufacture before 2016. Tash.
Rory, thank you.